Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going over to Kansas City, Missouri, where a gentleman noticed what looked like another small moon in the daytime sky above Kansas City, Missouri. Something extraordinary from the International Space Station, 250 miles above planet Earth, and it was on the camera that always looks down at the Earth, and something appeared in the field of view that should not have been there. We're going to come back and take a closer look at that video here in just a moment. Now I want to take you guys over to Kansas City, Missouri. You can find the original video link down below in the description box. Gentlemen noticed what looked like a moon in broad daylight. It's way up here in the distance, and to be honest, I don't know how he zeroed in on this thing. It was quite a ways away, but you're going to see what looks like either a small moon or a planetary body in broad daylight. And I'm going to show you guys what Jupiter looks like in the, at least in the evening sky, and what Venus looks like in the evening sky before dark, and you'll see that this is not Venus, this is not Jupiter. I don't know what this is, but he zooms in on something that looks like a little moon. Check this out. The first part of the video, I know, is a little wobbly. You got to keep in mind, he's doing this on the fly. Like most unusual things that we see in the sky, unexpectedly, you pull out your recording device and you just start recording freehand, and it's a little difficult to do, especially if it's a long ways away. In the second half of this video, I stabilize it. It's much more steady, and you're going to see an object that looks like a crescent moon. Check this out, or at least in a moon phase. He zooms in again. He was just trying to back out and then relocate it. This thing's a long ways away. It looks like it's outside the atmosphere. Looks like a little planetary body. Once again, we're seeing something in the sky that looks like a moon. Has the Earth picked up another moon that we're not aware of? We saw something unusual on the International Space Station live cam the other day that looked like a moon on the dark side of the Earth that impossibly was in between the camera and the Earth. So right here, I don't know if this is associated with that. This was noticed on November 29th of 2021. And here we go, full zoom out on the object to again get kind of a perspective of just how far away this was. Well beyond the clouds, totally outside the atmosphere. Again, I don't know how he saw this thing. That was an excellent observation. And again, to record this freehand on the fly, he did a pretty good job. So he recorded what looks like a small moon above Kansas City, Missouri on November 29th of 2021. I want to show you guys what Venus and Jupiter look like up against this object that he saw in the daylight sky. I recorded this yesterday from right out here in Arizona in my backyard. You've got Venus over here, you had Jupiter up here, and actually Saturn in the middle. It wasn't completely daylight, but it wasn't dark either. And I had this on a tripod. He was trying to do it freehand, so that's why this one's much more steady. If I'd had a telescope, you could see that this one, too, would be in a crescent phase, like this one here. This one's not because it's oversaturated with bright light, and I didn't have a telescope on it. This one here was big enough to reveal the phase, like a moon phase, and this one is actually in a phase, too. You just can't see it. But anyway, Venus on the right, the unknown object on the left. I zoom in on Jupiter yesterday evening around 5:36 p.m. Actually pulled forward some color in one of the photographs. Again, I filmed this on a tripod, so it's a lot smoother than the video we just saw. Here's the color that I pulled in of Jupiter in the evening sky. This would have been yesterday around 5:30 p.m. I'm going to compare this object with the object the gentleman saw above Kansas City, Missouri, and you're going to see there is no comparison. They're totally different. So the man did not see Jupiter in the daytime sky. He did not see Venus in the daytime sky. I don't know exactly what it was he saw, and neither did he. The upcoming planetary alignment's going to look kind of like this in the southern sky on December 10th. Saturn is right here in the center of Venus and Jupiter, and on the 10th, it's going to include the moon. There's Saturn right there, that little dot, and then back up here at the top is Jupiter, and then you're going to have the moon over here on the far left-hand side. So again, that alignment is coming up on December 10th of 2021, so don't forget to check that out. I want to take you guys now back over to the International Space Station. Once again, it's the camera that looks down at the Earth, whether the space station is on the daylight side of the Earth, like you see here in this photo, or if it's on the nighttime side of the Earth. Mary Hall, who monitors the International Space Station very closely, she watches this every day, doesn't miss a thing. Here's her YouTube channel, and you can see the majority of her uploads are from the International Space Station. Well, back on the 25th, on Thanksgiving, she noticed something around 8:40 p.m. She noticed something appear in the field of view. This is the video. I'm going to play the video, at least part of it. It's narrated by her friend, Dale DeFay, and he's explaining what you're seeing here in this video. And as the space station goes deeper into the dark side of the Earth, something appears into the field of view that actually caught the attention of one of the astronauts on the ISS. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to play part of the video that was narrated once again by her friend Dale.
Hello, welcome to Mary Hall's channel. My name is Dale DeFay. I'm going to narrate this extraordinary video for her. This is the ISS live feed, and this is facing the Earth going into the Terminator into nighttime, because the space station travels at excess of 16,500 miles an hour with the rotation of the Earth, going from west to east. So anything on the Earth will appear to go from right to left. But the important thing to realize is it's always facing towards Earth, this particular camera, and this object is always there. This is part of the space station. We can clearly see it now because it's capturing the sun, because this space station sits 265 miles from the surface of the Earth and still capturing the sun, even though the surface of the Earth is receiving no sun right now at all. It's going into the Terminator at night, heading east. And again, this is important to realize that this is always there, whether you see it or not. There's times during this video where you don't see this at all, but it's always there, which proves that this camera didn't change. This is important to keep this in mind as this video goes on. It's this like 17-minute video, but I can condense it a little bit here. I wanted to show this part, to show that this is always there, whether you see it or not. Now we'll go on. Here you can clearly see it. You start seeing all these speckles all over the place. That's the camera. And they even go all over this object, or this part of the space station, which again is always there. It's always, whether it's in view or not, it's always there. But it completely disappears as the darkness, as the sun stops reaching the space station. See there, it totally disappears. We don't even know it's there. But it's there. It's invisible right now, but it's there. And it's important to keep that in mind as this video goes on. You'll see what I'm talking about. But that's important because it's showing that the camera is always facing the Earth, because there's an extraordinary object that appears that it actually captures the attention of the astronauts. So let me zoom ahead here. Sometimes you'll see lights from city lights and things like that. Anything stationary on the Earth that's lit up will go from right to left. Now keep in mind that object is still there. Part of the space station. It's still there. Always will be, because the camera's not changing. We're moving. Watch this thing appear out from behind that. So this object here is between the camera and the surface of the Earth. So this, whatever this is, which again catches the astronauts' attention, because I'm sure they were supposed to take the live feed off now, because it does capture their attention. I think they're more intent on focusing in on this than they are of stopping the live feed. Because this is an extraordinary capture. We don't know what this thing is.
Okay, I want to add something here. Notice the red and blue. What those are pixels. Once they focus in on this object, you'll see those pixels disappear. And they're getting ready to focus in on that object right now.
Waiting to see it when they zoom in. But keep in mind, this is still facing the Earth. It's still the same camera. So this is a very large object that's going at relative speed with the space station. And in its orbit, in relative orbit as well, but as you can see, it's veering downwards. So this thing's going in excess of 16,500 miles an hour, 17,000 miles per hour, relative with the space station, and also going down. See, here's where they focus in. They didn't change cameras. Mary proves that by looking up over here in the check-in. See how they're zooming in on it now? This thing really caught their attention. Now, what does that look like to you? It looks just like the moon, doesn't it? And I'll show you why it can't be. For two reasons. First of all, again, this camera didn't change. This is the same live feed. See how the camera's trying to pick up the light on it? Look at the extraordinary features on this. It looks very similar to our moon, but it couldn't be, because there's big bumps on it, big bumps like mountains. It's incredible. And again, it caught the attention of the astronauts. They didn't switch the camera. It's still the same camera. You don't see the spots and things anymore. We because they zoomed in, and they're going to pan out on this thing too, so it doesn't lose the frame. So this is between the space station and the Earth. This orbit is lower than the space station and going just as fast. And it looks just like a moon, and it's eclipsed just like our moon is. This thing really caught their attention, and they didn't switch cameras. Mary proves that by prudently looking up at the reference up here in the upper left corner to see if it's the same camera, which it is. And this object, part of the space station, is still here. I can't see it right now because the light's not catching it, but the light is certainly catching this thing. See, the HD camera, HD, it's the same one pointing towards the Earth. They didn't switch cameras. This thing is between the space station and the Earth, my friends. And she also checks it at the end and switches it to the other camera, which shows nothing but static. So they didn't switch cameras. This is the one facing towards the Earth. This is a phenomenal object.
I want to pause it right here, and I want to narrate a little bit myself. Dale does an excellent job analyzing this video footage. It is extraordinary. I mean, the moon would not fit between the International Space Station and the Earth. You got to keep in mind, this is 250 miles, 260 miles above the surface of the Earth. For something like that to come in between the field of view of the camera and the surface of the Earth, it would have to be, you know, much smaller than 250 miles. The moon's over 2,000 miles wide. This, however, looks like the moon, but it's impossible for it to be the moon. And if you've ever seen what the moon looks like from the International Space Station, it's always right here next to the surface of the Earth in that area they call the thin blue line. In fact, I Googled it, and this is what it looks like, just like that right there. See all these different photos of the moon from the International Space Station? See that? And it always includes the surface of the Earth in some capacity, whether it's far away like that, not way up in the darkness like that. It's always at least very close to the surface of the Earth. What you're seeing right here just appeared in the middle of the backside of the Earth. You don't see the thin blue line. You don't see any of that. And this video goes on. It went on for 17 minutes, and you can find the entire video over here again at Mary Hall's YouTube channel. Dale did an excellent job trying to analyze that. And what he was telling you guys was this thing appeared from out behind this structure right here, this piece of the International Space Station. It came into view as it was being blocked by this thing right here. This is a part of the space station. And when it came into the field of view, they actually zoomed in on it. Again, I want to reiterate, that was the same camera that's looking down at the surface of the Earth the entire time. Where did that thing come from? And what is it? I looked at near-Earth asteroids, and I did find one that's very large.
Well, heads up, if you live on planet Earth, guess that's all of us, a giant asteroid hurtling toward our planet, expected to intersect with Earth's orbit next week. On the 11th of December, the asteroid will be at its closest proximity to Earth in 20 years.
It was first spotted back in 1994 and was classified as being an Earth impact risk until 2016.
The asteroid is as wide as a football field is long and is considered potentially dangerous because of its size and its proximity to our planet. And then it'll be about 10 times farther away than the moon. So you can breathe now.
We turn now to what sounds like the premise of a sci-fi movie.
It looks very similar to our moon, but it couldn't be because there's high, big bumps on it, big bumps like mountains.
But why some say the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? 535 years ago, fly the Atlantic. We choose to go to the moon and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
We'll be right back. This is not real. This isn't happening. Kate, tell me this isn't really happening.
I hear there's something you don't like the looks of.
We discovered a very large comet.
Oh, good for you.
It's headed directly towards Earth.
This comet is what we call a planet killer.
At this exact moment, I say we sit tight and assess.
Sit tight and assess?
Sit tight.
And then assess. The sit tight part comes first, and you gotta digest it. That's the assessment period.
This is the worst news in the history of humanity. He just blew us off.
What are we gonna do? We have to release the information.
So we just leak it.
Our guests today have made a pretty big discovery in space.
How big is this thing going? I can't destroy my ex-wife's house. Is that possible?
There's a 100% chance that we're all going to die.
Hey.
Well, the handsome astronomer can come back anytime, but the yelling lady, not so
much. Not so much.
We're going to get the news out there one way or another.
It's real and it's coming.
FBI!
Jesus Christ, you could have just called me.
This comet contains $30 trillion worth of material.
What do trillions of dollars matter if we're all going to die?
Oh, no, this what if we're rich? That would be terrible.
You guys discovered a comet? I have a tattoo of a shooting star on my back.
Oh, that's terrific. This could be a complete disaster.
This is already a disaster.
You know that girl from YFTV said we're all gonna die?
No.
Your girl! You'll never take me alive! There it is!
A giant comet! Hurling its way towards Earth!
Can you see it?
I can't! My head is in a bag!
I did have the FBI put that bag over your head. They don't do that. The CIA does, but I made them do it.
You know, I had a feeling.
It's a good feeling, because that is what I did, and it was very funny and cool.
NASA today, in a first-of-its-kind mission, launched a spacecraft named DART towards an asteroid.
Early tomorrow morning, a spacecraft is going to make its way toward an asteroid.
For the first time, a NASA spacecraft will try to knock an asteroid off course.
Liftoff. NASA just launched Earth's first planetary defense mission, DART.
More than 27,000 near-Earth asteroids, seen here in blue, have been identified so far.
10,000 seem big enough to cause a calamity if they were to hit our planet. In 2013, a small asteroid, roughly 60 feet across, exploded over Russia.
Look out. In the 1998 sci-fi thriller Armageddon, an asteroid the size of Texas is on a collision course with planet Earth.
The United States government just asked us to save the world.
And actor Bruce Willis jumps in to save us all.
You're going to remote detonate the bomb.
We're not prepared for this.
Incoming!
T-minus 3, 2, 1.
Go for ignition.
July 20th.
1969. It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
In school, you were taught that Apollo 11 lost contact with the world for 2 minutes. Not true. Found something on that day that they kept hidden for 50 years. And now, it's too late to stop.
In breaking news, the governor has just ordered the mass evacuation of the entire West Coast.
Moving to higher ground is the only possible chance of surviving.
Stay awake, my brothers and sisters! Stay awake!
This planet has suffered 5 extinctions. This is going to be the 6th.
dead?
No, we are just inside the moon.
That might be the greatest sentence anyone's ever said.
This thing is over 3,000 feet wide, and it's not anywhere that close to the Earth. It would have been nowhere in between the space station and the Earth. It wouldn't have been here, or at least it shouldn't have been. Let's put it that way. This is NEO 2003 SD220. I mean, this thing's really big, and it's not due to make a close approach for a few more days, so it would not have been what came between the Earth and the camera. This, whatever it is, looks like our moon. In fact, here's a screen grab of the object. It does look almost identical to the moon, but there's no way it could have been the moon because, again, it was the same camera pointing down at the Earth. And if you've ever seen the moon from the International Space Station, this is what it normally looks like. It doesn't appear very often, but when it does, it's normally close to the atmosphere of the Earth. It's normally close to the surface of the Earth with regard to the position of the camera and the International Space Station. For it to appear like that in the dark side of the Earth in between the space station and the camera is pretty much impossible. At least I've never seen it. Dale had never seen anything like it. Mary obviously had never seen anything like it. That's what compelled her to record this. It was an extraordinary find, whatever this was, unless, like Mary said, unless NASA was doing something up there that we're not aware of. But they seem to be surprised by the side of this thing as well. That's why they zoomed in on it. That was not Mary zooming in. That was the operator of the camera zooming in on this object that does look like our moon. Something appeared in the camera on the dark side of the Earth that came between the space station and the Earth while traveling on the dark side of the Earth that looks like the moon, which is technically impossible. How did that happen? How did something like that appear literally out of nowhere? It comes out from behind a piece of the International Space Station, as you'll see right there. This did not switch cameras. It remained on the same camera the entire time. Kind of drifts south throughout the duration of the video. Again, it's a very long video. You can check it out over at Mary's YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe to her YouTube channel. And I'm telling you, Mary does not miss much, especially when it comes to that International Space Station. So once again, great observation by Mary Hall. From high above the Earth on the International Space Station, a mysterious object comes into the field of view on the dark side of the Earth.